There's the final call tonight, and victory number 200 for the man who joins us now, head coach Buzz Williams. And coach, without saying congratulations, but I wanted to play that highlight because I thought you'd like the full band part, because particularly the journey to get to 200. I know the roads have been everywhere, not just in Blacksburg and across this country, and just your thoughts on it and all the people that have been a part of it, including those here at Tech.
Yeah, you know, I've been thinking about what is it that you say when something like this happens, and I don't know that I could have capsulized it better than what you said. There's been a lot of people that have done a lot of things on my behalf that never had to. And if you're from the country, the way they say that more succinctly is, I'm just a turtle on a fence post. That means a lot of people have helped me get there. And it's not one thing, it's not one person. I should have never got the job as the head coach at New Orleans. They'd already interviewed four guys on campus when the AD called me. Absolutely no way in the world I should have got the job at Marquette. I had a losing record as a head coach. The guy that I worked for 8 months left. And the only reason I got the job, obviously, is because of God. But it was a vice president and an AD who were strong enough to say, this is what we want. And only because of what transpired there was I able to have an opportunity to come here. But, you know, I think the reason that it's all worked out is when I was a manager at a junior college, all I was thinking about was, I wonder if someday I could be an assistant coach here. And then I went to an NAIA school, and I was a manager, and the only thing I was thinking was, I can't believe that my dream was to be an assistant coach in junior college. I should be trying to be an assistant coach at this NAIA school. And each step of the way, my paradigm increased just enough for me to be able to process it and handle it in the right way. And I've always tried to repay all of the guys that have hired me. I've hired all of them in some capacity or another, except for one. And it's not me. It's all of those players and all of those coaches that have allowed me the opportunity to grow. And this is my 10th year as a head coach, and it's my 16th and a half year of marriage. And if you don't marry the right teammate, none of that works. And so it's a combination of all of those things. And I feel incredibly blessed and honored. But more than any of that, I'm somewhat in awe of it all. And the only reason I'm taking time to talk to you guys is I won't feel comfortable saying that to the people in the print media. But I do think that there are some people that listen to our show or whatever this would be called that understand what I'm saying. And I'm in awe of it, and I hope that maybe we can do a few more.
And what is so cool about it is on a night like tonight, when it's the suits and sneakers and coaches versus cancer, your outfit, your pink belt.
Yeah, thanks.
I mean, you're styling and profiling, and there's so much more to life than basketball. But just to have it on this night makes it kind of extra cool.
Well, I think what I'm learning the more it goes is it's really not the numbers as much as it is the number of lives that are impacted. And Corey and I talk about this a lot. You know, I used to think about things 5 years ago, 10 years ago. It's almost as if I'm not the same person. But that's just because of the maturation on the path that God's had me on. And I think that the reason that path has continued to progress is because the lessons that I've learned is it's not about ball. Ball's fun, but we're using it to try to help change people's lives. And that doesn't just mean the players. I hope that it means the assistant coaches. I hope that it means the support staff. I hope that it means the managers, because I used to be one of those managers. And it's a dream bigger than any that I ever had. And that's why I don't exactly know how to articulate it in the right way, because it wasn't like I was a good player or my dad was a coach and I worked for my dad and then it just worked out that way. I'm the guy, if you pick it out, I'm the one that's not supposed to belong. And so I want to make sure that I'm flipping the blessing and paying it forward, no matter who that person is.
Win number 200 for head coach Buzz Williams, 85-79, the final over Boston College. Buzz, we wanted your help in sorting out this stat sheet, as only you can do for us, because it's kind of a chicken and the egg stat sheet, isn't it? You have 17 fewer shots than they do, but you shoot the basketball exceptionally well. You get out-rebounded, but again, you shoot the basketball exceptionally well. Was those numbers skewed because you shot it so well, or did shooting it well override the fact that you did some of those other things not to the level you would have liked?
Similar to what you said, it'll probably be a segment on Tech Talk Live tomorrow. It's hard to diagnose it. Obviously, we shot the ball better, so there's not as many rebounds to get. We attempted 30 free throws, which is another reason why there wasn't as many field goal attempts. They had more field goal attempts, partly because they had offensive rebounds. The one thing that I would say is I thought Med came back to life. I thought Bibbs came back to life. I thought the ball was moving in the air way more than on the ground. I think Seth is continuing to play at a very high level. I don't know if it was his career high, but it's for sure his high thus far this season. He was averaging 1.4 rebounds in conference play. That was one every 21 minutes, and tonight he had six. Rebounding is going to be and is our Achilles heel. So how, no matter what the defense is, can we only allow those guys one shot? Obviously, 25 had a career night. Much of our focus and what we were trying to do was predicated on 0 and 1, and rightfully so. But 25 is a 23-year-old sophomore, and he is an elite-level shooter and got in an incredible rhythm. But I thought that how we responded to that run was what I was encouraged by the most. You know, all those different things that we're always talking about, it's 100ths of a point difference one way or another. And as I told our guys, we just need to continue to hug that, because that's the way it's going to become, and that's the way it has been.
Seems like the zone defense, you're getting another semester under your belt, that worked better, and you weren't out of rotation as much tonight.
Well, you know, you can't just look, in my opinion, burn up at the field goal percentage. But if you do, and we're trying to get 2% better offensively and 2% better defensively. So entering tonight's game, we were second in field goal percentage defense at 48.3%, and tonight we shoot 59.1. Thankful to be back at home, thankful that Bibbs and Med kind of came back to life and that the ball was being shared and moved the way that we want it to. And then defensively, 44% is much better than our field goal percentage defense entering today. Entering today, it was 49.1%, and it's just fractions, right? You know, 1% based on the tempo of the game. 1% may mean one more stop and one more basket. And when you get to February, that's what this becomes. One more stop, one more rebound, one more free throw, one more assist, one more dive on the floor, because that's just part of what every team is going through at this time of the year.
Last one for head coach Buzz Williams, who again wins his 200th career game tonight as the Hokies push back above 500 in ACC play, and then we'll pick it up on Tech Talk Live. Coach, what does it say about your team and where they are right now, the response when your lead was taken down to 1 in the second half? It was a 10-2 run, and everyone contributed.
Yeah, I thought I mentioned that, ladies, in the post game, and we actually talked about it in the pregame. It's going to be hard. And how you handle things when it gets hard is what's going to determine the result. And what you can't try to dispel is, oh, it's hard and it's going to go away on its own. It's not. And similar to what we were talking about earlier, that is true for their life. That is true for our lives. That's true for the people that are listening. It's not always going to go right. When it's going right, we appreciate it and we're grateful. But when it begins to go wrong, I think, and I know it's a 44-year-old version of it, when it begins to go wrong, hey guys, we gotta learn from what's going wrong and how to overcome it, because it's gonna go wrong again, and we have to have some experience and some wisdom of, this is how we handled it the last time and this is how we need to handle it this time. And so I thought our response today, maybe in that regard, was as good as it's been in conference play. I don't know if we're going to, entering today, we had played 7 games of 2 possessions or less. since we've been here, if you talk about only ACC teams, we've played more 1 and 2 possession games than anybody else. The more reps we've had of it, then I would hope that we're better at it. And one other thing I wanted to say that I meant to say earlier that was on my mind when I was getting ready for the game. As a head coach, no matter how many games you win and no matter how many games you lose, you're a head coach because that means you have a team to coach. And many times, it's not always a two-parent household. Many times, it's a mom. Many times, it's an uncle. Many times, it's a coach that's had a priority relationship with that young kid throughout his life. Without their trust in you and your staff and the foundation of what your program is going to be about, you don't have a team. And I think that our team in the 3 years that we have been here exemplify what our staff is about. They exemplify what our culture represents. And whether you talk to them on air or off air or on the bus or in the classroom or outside the state of Virginia, I'm proud of those families that entrusted us with their children, and I'm proud of who their children are and the path that they're on to become as young men, future husbands, future fathers, and in the end, I think that's how we'll all be judged. So I want to make sure that I say thank you to those parents that trusted us.
Absolutely. And a phenomenal place to end it with head coach Buzz Williams. Coach, congratulations to you, the team, and the family.
Thank you.
Enjoy it with all of them.
Go have fun with that medium.